Hi, welcome to my channel. If you need to run any of the projects I share here, stick around because in this video, I'll walk you through the process step by step. So let's get started. First of all, go to the download link provided in the description of each video. This will take you to a file hosted on Google Drive. Click download to get the file. Once you have the file, right click on the compressed folder and select extract all. This will give you access to all the project files. Inside a project folder, you'll find a file containing the database script. Copy all the code from the script and open your favorite database management tool. In this video, I'm using MariaDB, but any MySQL compatible tool will work. Run the script to create the necessary tables. Once the database is set up, the first thing you need to do is add a record to the company table. This step is crucial for the project to work properly. Manually insert the data into the table using your database management tool and make sure the company table has at least one record before proceeding. Edit the project's configuration file to set up the database connection and make sure to include your username, password, and database name. For the project to work, you will need to install Node.js. I have included a link to download it in the video description. So, download and install Node.js by following the installer instructions. Once Node.js is installed, navigate to the project folder. In the address bar at the top of the file explorer, type cmd and press enter. This will open that console directly in the project's folder. In that console, type the following command: npm start. This will start a project server and display the port it's running on. Open your preferred browser and type localhost and the port number. That's it, you'll now see the project up and running. If you encounter a license expire message, don't worry, here's how to fix it. Open the project in your favorite code editor, navigate to the public folder and open the file name script.js. Press Ctrl F, search for the word license, and locate the function related to license verification. Delete that function, save the changes, refresh the browser, and that issue will be resolved. That is all for this video. I hope this guide helped you successfully run the projects I share here on the channel. If you'd like to see more free projects and code, consider making a voluntary donation. Thank you for your support. Don't forget to subscribe, leave a like, and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos. See you on the next project.